week on Sex Bytes, we're talking masturbation, aka self-manipulation of one's genitalia. And let me tell you, this occurs all across the animal kingdom in a wide variety of contexts. Now, there are three main hypotheses to explain the near ubiquitous occurrence of masturbation in the animal kingdom. First of all, the sexual tension, the sexual release kind of hypotheses that essentially state that everybody needs a break once in a while, and to relieve the tension, masturbation is a good thing. The fresh ejaculate hypotheses have to do with the fact that sperm declines in quality and motility as it ages. And so it makes sense for males, of course, to keep it fresh, keep it coming, in order to make sure that you will be most successful at fertilizing a lady partner when you get the chance to do so. Thirdly, and this has been shown mostly in ground squirrels, males will actually masturbate to decrease their chances of contracting a sexually transmitted disease. Now, a recent study has thrown a fourth hypothesis into the mix, and this study was done on rhesus macaques, or primates, that are actually, of course, quite closely related to us humans. Researchers noticed that male social rank had quite a bit to do with how much he masturbated. So the high-ranking males got a lot of action with the females, and of course, didn't masturbate as much, compared to the low-ranking males, who, of course, didn't get as much action with the ladies, and of course, masturbated a lot. Not terribly surprising. But what was interesting is that in only 15% of cases did ejaculation occur. So all of these guys are masturbating, but they're not ejaculating, which is kind of perplexing. So they threw a couple of hypotheses into the mix about why this might be occurring. The first could be a stress and anxiety reliever, especially if you are living in a group of very promiscuous primates and you're always looking to get some and you can't seem to find a partner or aren't allowed to have a partner. Well, it makes sense to slap your own salami and deal with that. But that doesn't explain the lack of ejaculation, and that virtually negates the three hypotheses that I discussed before. All of those require ejaculation to occur. So what's going on here? Well, the second hypothesis that these researchers proposed makes more sense to me, and this is called the sexual arousal hypothesis. Essentially, these males, these subordinate males, are keeping themselves in a constant state of arousal in case they get a chance at a female, and if they do, they can have sex with her and ejaculate within her in a much quicker time period than if they weren't ready to go, so to speak. And this makes sense. If you are a sneaking male, a subordinate male, that's perhaps needing to do this under the watchful eye of the alpha, you want to get in and out as quickly as possible. And this has also been shown in Galapagos iguanas, who actually masturbate to climax, store the sperm in little pouches by their penis, and wait for just the right opportunity to sneak onto a male's territory and slam it into a female. And that's called sexual reproduction in the animal kingdom. Humans are pretty lucky.